Hi guys, my name is Kate Kendall. I'm the co-founder and director of yoga at Flow Athletic in Paddington, and I'm the author of Life in Flow. And I'm excited today to be joining you on Stylerunner Health Club for this Mellow Flow. Hi guys, excited to be here with you today. I'm going to take you through a little Mellow Flow so we can really lean into our kind of harmonic, easygoing side. And if you like this little sip of a practice, you can join me this Wednesday coming actually. Flow Athletic, we're doing a Flow After Dark Yoga Silent Disco live stream. So if you've never been to one of our actual events before, they're pretty cool, soul expanding. Everyone has earphones. I've got a DJ next to me, and it's a really cool kind of flowing class. And this time around, so we did a live stream a couple of weeks ago. This time around, it's the Mellow edition. It's a 60-minute vinyasa class. So you can jump onto my Active Yogi page to grab tickets. It's just $10. So, you know, hang out virtually with your mates in their own living room, and I'll see you then. Before that, though, let's flow mellow style. So come onto your mat or just a piece of carpet at home. And we'll move into a child's pose to ground down. So separate your knees. Have your big toes touching and reach your arms all the way out in front. And make it a little bit active to begin with. So just move your hips a little bit side to side, spread through the fingers and gaze forward so that the back of the neck perhaps feels a little shorter. And if I think about mellow as kind of an element, to me it feels a little bit like a combination between earth and water. Take a generous breath in, and as you exhale, rest your forehead, your arms down to the ground. Let everything soften. And while you're just chilling there on the ground, breathing, starting to cultivate a deeper, kind of fluid, round, full breath. Those qualities of the earth are really kind of steady, stable, consistent, like it's always there. And then that element of water is really fluid and easygoing. Yeah, so we've got both the element of being really grounded and really fluid through these two elements. So you might even feel to embody them. And just right now, connecting with that solid structure underneath you of the earth. And take one more breath in, as if you're borrowing that breath from the earth. And a long breath out. Slowly make your way up onto all fours. So your hands are under the shoulders and the knees are under the hips. The fingers are spread generously. Press your palms, your knees into the earth. Curl the toes under. So you're spreading through the toes, and inhale, drop the navel, tilt the tail, and broaden your collarbones. And as you exhale, round out through the spine, so chin to throat, tailbone tucks, make that feel good for the neck, the shoulders, the back. Again, inhale, drop the navel, tilt the tail, broaden your collarbones. And exhale, slowly round out. So if mellow had a felt experience in the body, how would it feel right now, and how would it move? Fluidly, perhaps, aware of the earth underneath. So get a little playful with it. And if you're ready to, take that with you into a downward facing dog. And from your downward facing dog, so we'll come back to this, just walk your feet very slowly, swing the hips side to side to the very top of the mat, so that eventually the feet are about hip distance apart, about hip distance. Flat back, lift your chest, broaden the collarbones. We don't want to get too stuck on our alignment today. Make it a little more fluid. Exhale, fold forward, soften the knees a whole lot, and drop the head. Again, flat back, lift the chest like there's a wave moving through your spine. And fold forwards as you exhale. Once again, flat back, you can bend your knees any amount if that feels softer and gentler on the lower back. And exhale, fold forwards into a ragdoll, grab a hold of your elbows, let the head drop, let your torso sway a little side to side. Feel the breath circulate with ease.
through the entire body. And take your hands to the ground, bend the knees some more, begin to roll up bone by bone, feeling the spine unfurl, the arms are dangling, the head dangles. Take your heel hand to the forehead and just help your head up that last little bit. And drop your hands down by your side. Take the arms out and up, reach up nice and slow, we're in no rush. And exhale, fold forward, soften the knees a whole lot, drop the head. Here we are again, a flat back, lift your chest and broaden the collarbones. Exhale, step the right foot back behind you, lower the right knee gently to the ground, and take your arms out and up. Reach up, your palms face each other. As you exhale, sink your hips down, soften your gaze. Have another breath to lift the hips up. The breath out to sink down, take your hands to the ground, lean back into this half split position, peel the toes of left foot up and back. And as you exhale, come back to lunge. Take your left knee back to the right. Reach the arms out in front of you. Generous breath in, Anahatasana. And stay there for the exhalation. Curl your toes under. Inhale. Come stand up onto the knees. Reach up. Palms connect. Exhale, hands right down through center. Sit onto your heels. Two more times. We repeat that. Stand up onto the knees, reach your arms up, lift the gaze, and exhale, back down. One more time, lift up, reach up, lengthen up, open the chest. Exhale, hands out in front, slither down to the ground so your bottom's in the air, chest lands, and belly, then hips. Cobra pose, draw your shoulder blades onto the back, and wave the chest forwards and up. And exhale, come back down. So we move with the breath. Either hands to ground or fingertips off the edge. Again, come up as you inhale. Exhale, back down. So using the assistance of the earth underneath, press into it to wave the chest up fluidly. And exhale, back down. Hands under shoulders, press back. Child's pose, breath in. And a nice long breath out. Inhale, come forwards onto all fours. And exhale, downward facing dog. Couple of breaths. And your palms completely flat, fingers spread. You might take some little movements through the legs and spine to defrost, to decompress, to remind you to stay fluid. And as you're ready, float your right leg up and back as you inhale. Exhale, right foot quietly through, lower your left knee gently. Take your left fingertips off the edge of the mat, float your right hand forwards and up, reach up, lean back, big circle with that right arm. Exhale, right hand to inner right foot, turn to your left, skandhasana, lunge into the left leg. So we'll lift the hips a little bit as we inhale and sink right back down, close to the earth. Inhale, turn to face your right foot, stay low to the ground and step forward so that your left foot only just lands around about now and you fold forwards. Inhale, take your arms out and up, reach up. To be mellow or to move with ease, exhale, hands right down through center, might be to take our time. Take the arms out and up, second side, and to feel everything. Fold forwards, it's like we plunge into every posture, kind of lingering in the places that feel good. Flat back, lift your chest. Left foot steps back, exhale, lower your left knee gently to the ground. Take your arms out and up, reach up. And then dial the tailbone down as you sink the hips down to explore that space in your left hip flexor. Lift the hips a little bit as you inhale. And sink back down as you exhale. Take the hands to ground, lean back. Half Hanuman, peel the toes, spread through every single one of them. And exhale, come back to lunge. Slide your right knee back to the left. Stretch the arms out in front, reach out, lengthen out, breath in. Long breath out. Curl the toes under, come stand up onto the knees, reach your arms up. Right, bring the knees a little closer together. Perhaps exhale, sit down onto the heels, the toes are curled under. Inhale, reach up. Exhale. Inhale, come up. And when you come up into like the peak of each posture, you might leave space for a little movement like I am, side to side of hips or anything else that feels good. Exhale, hands through center, out in front, slither down. Three little back bends using fingertips or hands. Leave the chest. And if you find a place that feels nice, welcome just to linger there instead of moving. And if you're lingering and staying, kind of holding a posture, it's less a hold and more of a watching and exploration of the breath. One more breath in. Exhale, come down. Child's pose. Press back, seat to heels, breath in. And a beautiful long breath out to ground down. Inhale, round forwards, all fours, and exhale, downward facing dog, couple of breaths, replant the hands. To be in stillness or movement, doesn't matter, make sure it's conscious though, so not just moving because it feels uncomfortable. You might feel nice here to soften knees and ease the tailbone up and back, that can give your shoulders and your spine a little more space. We float the left leg up and back to inhale. Exhale, the left foot gently through. Take your right fingertips off the mat, lower the right knee, take your left hand forwards in a big, big circle, open the chest. Exhale, left hand to inner left foot. Turn to your right, skandhasana. Want to stay nice and low to the ground. As you inhale, lift the hips a little bit. As you exhale, sink down. Stay low, inhale, turn to face left foot, step forwards nice and slowly, flat back, lift the chest, landing the right foot of that. Now as you exhale, fold forwards. Inhale, take your arms out and up, reach up, stand tall, perhaps there's a little back bend, mellow back bend, super gentle. Exhale, hands right down through center, have a little moment just to feel, to breathe, to let the eyes close or get steady out in front. To feel the beat of the heart, to notice the temperature of your skin, all those sensations within. Okay, press your two feet into the earth, so you can press down into the earth and feel it give back in support. Take the arms out and up, reach up. Exhale, fold forwards. Same deal, just one breath per movement. Flat back, lift the chest. It's like you're slow dancing with the breath. Exhale, right foot steps back, lower your right knee. Inhale, take your hands out and up. Perhaps there's a mellow little back bend here, curiously exploring that space. Exhale, hands to ground, lean back, half plank and peel the toes. Exhale, re-lunge, left knee back to right. Breath out, reach out into the fingertips. Stay there for the exhalation. You might now rest on the chin for a fraction. Slide the hands in towards you. Come stand up onto the knees just the one time. Reach up. Exhale, hands out in front. You might come into chaturanga so that your knees lift. Low plank. And then to cobra or upward facing, drawing the shoulder blades together on the back. And from the pit of your belly, lift up, roll over the toes, downward facing. Right leg rises as you inhale. Bend your right knee and roll that right hip open to the sky. And exhale, right foot gently through. Keep the left knee lifted this time. Take the left fingertips off the ground. Sweep the right hand forwards and up, lean back. Exhale, turn to the left, skandhasana. Keep the fingertips grounded, but walk them over to the left side this time so your right side waist gets nice and long. And stay there. We'll just squeeze that left leg a little straighter for a moment and then sink it back down, lunge into that left leg. Inhale, turn to face your right foot. Step forwards, flat back, with the chest, left foot lands around about now as you fall forwards. Inhaling. Exhaling. Left side, inhaling. Float forwards, exhaling. Inhaling, flat back. Exhaling, left foot steps back. Lower that left knee. Take the arms out and up. Press into your right foot. Keep your front floating ribs in as you lift the chest and arms out. Exhale, hands to frame the right foot. Lean back, half Hanuman. Breathe in. Feel that in the belly of your right hamstring. Exhale, we lunge. Anahatasana, right knee meets the left. Stretch out, reach out. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, stand up onto the knees, reach out. Exhale, perhaps chaturanga or move yourself to the ground. Cobra or upward facing. And eventually, we all move back to downward facing. Left leg rises as we inhale. Bend the left knee, roll that left hip open to the sky, spread through the toes. Left foot through between the hands, keep your right leg lifted. Right fingertips off the edge of the mat, left arm out and up. Big circle as you lean back. Exhale, turn to your right, Skandhasana. Then wander your fingertips out to the right side, so the left side waist gets long. Stay there or squeeze the right leg straight as you inhale. And exhale, relunge. Stay low to the ground, turn to face your left foot, step forwards, flat back, lift your chest, fold, forwards, exhale. How about this, flat back, lift the chest, take your peace fingers of each hand around the big toes, so the wrists face each other, take a flat back as you inhale, lift the chest, knees can be as bent as they need to get that long spine. We use an exhalation to bend the elbows out to the side and fold forwards. Let's do that two more times. Two more undulations. Lift the chest. Exhale, fold forwards. Inhaling. Fold forwards. Exhale. This time, pause. You're using the fingers around the big toes to ease you into the posture, but we relax the shoulders. We use the biceps a little bit. We press down into whatever parts of the feet are grounded. We internally rotate the thighs. And lift the sit bones up and forwards a little bit. One more breath in. Stay for that exhalation. Lift up halfway, inhale, turn your toes out, heels in. Sit down into yogi squat on the last. And bring your palms together, press your elbows into the inner knees. And then the inner knees into the elbows. And what a beautiful posture to put yourself in. It's really nice one for digestion. Great for the back, the hips, the groin. Great for being able to squat in any of your other athletic pursuits. Take one more breath in. Stay there for the exhalation. Take your left hand out to the left side, right arm out and up, reach up, gaze up, stay there or wrap your left hand back behind you to seek out your inner left thigh. And if you're taking that variation, gaze just beyond the right shoulder, a couple of breaths. Turn your gaze forwards, release the hand, step your left foot back behind you. Lower the left knee, lizard lunge. Sink the hips, broaden the collarbone. Sway the hips a little side to side. Like you got a river running through you. Lean back as you inhale, peel the toes. They're turned out a little bit here. And exhale, come back to lunge. Do that twice more, that flossing kind of action, forwards and back with breath. Inhale, might feel nice to close down the eyes. And exhale. Inhale, lean back, peel the toes. And exhale, come forwards. Either stay here uplifted or come down on onto your forearms. You can also place your forearms onto some blocks or some books just to get a little more height if you needed it. So any kind of props that we use, just think of them as extensions of the earth. You keep it really mellow like this. Give it a little more spice by curling your left toes under, pressing back into the left heel and broadening the collarbones forwards. Couple of breaths. Lowering that left knee down to the ground. Come on up, take your left fingertips off the edge of the mat. Right hand forwards and up, reach up. Either stay there with the right fingertips towards the back of the mat, or bend your left knee, catch a hold of your left ankle with the right hand, and give that left quadricep a big old rinse. Allow yourself to be fluid with it. Allow those little movements that occur naturally with the breath to occur. So we want to clamp down, hold down rigidly. We want to be fluid, curious of the sensations. Two more breaths. And then gently drop that back foot, child's pose, right knee meets the left, breath in, stretch the arms out wide, knees a little wider than hip distance. Exhale, forehead to ground. Slide the hands in towards you. So sitting back onto the heels, take the left hand back behind you, right hand forwards and up. Press the hips forwards, roll your chest open to any degree until you feel an edge down your right side. This is so nice. And then come back down, switch sides. Right hand back, left hand forwards and up, reach up. And then come back down, bring the knees together, take your hands out in front, perhaps a little connecting vinyasa. Or straight to down dog. So I'm going to come forwards into chaturanga. Back bend of choice, nice and slowly feel it all. And then move yourself back. Downward dog. Right. Try something without thinking it through too much. Lift up high onto your tippy toes as you inhale. As you exhale, bend the knees, look forwards, hop forwards like a frog into malasana. Yogi squat, hopefully not with too much noise, it takes practice. Bring the palms together, elbows to the inner knees. Press knees to elbows, elbows to knees, sink the tailbone down and lengthen into the crown. And could you apply, curiously, an attitude of ease? An attitude of ease to this posture when it doesn't always necessarily feel so ease or full. Take your right hand out to the right side, left arm out and up, reach up, because maybe mellow and ease is an attitude. Stay there, take your left hand back behind you, seek out your inner right thigh, and wherever you are, so gaze beyond the left shoulder. One more breath in. Exhale, turn your head back down, release that left hand, step your right foot back into a lizard lunge. So we lower the right knee, left big toe, knee pointing in the same direction. Sink the hips, broaden the collarbones, pride chest, little moment and sink and sway. Breathe, like you could breathe down into your hips. Lean back to half Hanuman, peel the toes. Exhale, come back to lunge a couple of times with breath. Slow dancing with the breath. Lean back, back of neck long. Exhale, sink. Last time, lean back, peel the toes. So come back into your lizard lunge, stay there upright, nice little back bend variation, or you come down onto your forearms or onto blocks. get familiar with the sensations in this shape just here before moving on. So we skim over nothing. Every single variation of a posture brings with it new opportunities for space, for freedom. Stay there or curl your right toes under, lift the right knee and press firmly back into that right heel. There's a kind of squeezing of the inner thighs in towards each other. Just kind of draws everything, magnetizes everything to the midline of the body. One more breath. And then lower that right knee, come up out of it, take your right fingertips off the edge of the mat. Sweep your left hand forwards and up. Big circle, keep the left fingertips right back behind you. It's a beautiful twist. And lunge, or bend your right knee, catch a hold of your right ankle with the left hand. And as you send the tailbone down and forwards, you're also at the same time rotating through the upper body, the spine is a little twist, left shoulder gets a little opening, no matter what shape we're in here. Steady gaze, soft eyes, or close them. Feel what you feel. One more breath in. Exhale, release that back foot. If it's lifted, child's pose. Slide the left knee back to the right. Knees a little wider than hip distance. Have a moment to sink, surrender, and to soften into the earth. Slide the hands in towards you. Take the right hand back behind you first this time. Left hand forwards and up. Press the hips forwards. Stay there or bend your left elbow. Take your hand behind the head. Feels okay to draw your left shoulder over towards the left side of you. Roll the chest open. Press the hips forwards. One more breath. Oh, and then come down. Switch sides. Left hand back behind you. Right hand forwards and up. Press the hips forwards. Again, stay there with a long right arm or bend the elbow, hand behind head for some support. And then you lean back into that hand. Offer the heart skyward and the hips forward. And then come back down. Have a little moment there just to feel. Close the eyes and just be in the inner environment. Open. Bring the knees together. Take your hands out in front of you. Again, don't think about this one. Just cross your ankles. Slide your feet through. And cross your legs. So your right leg is in front of the left. The feet are flexed. Take the arms out and up. Interlace the hands. Press the palms skyward. Exhale. Round out through the spine. Chin to throat. Tailbone tucks. Make that feel nice for the neck. Press the palms away and up, inhale. Exhale, cactus arms, elbows out to the side, broaden the collarbones. Reach up as you inhale, interlace and extend forwards. Flex the feet, hands to ground, have a few moments either just to sway side to side or to be still. This would be a really nice time to lengthen out the exhalations. So they feel twice as long as the in-breath. And then interlace your hands to inhale. Come up, reach up, lengthen up and twist to the right. Left hand to right knee, right hand back behind you. Lengthen through the spine as you inhale and twist. So gently as you exhale. And turn your gaze forwards. Inhale, take the arms out. Reach up, lengthen the spine again and twist to the left. In, long, slow breath out. Turn the gaze forwards, release that, switch sides, lean back. Left leg in front of the right, take the arms out and up, flex the feet, interlace. Exhale, round out, chin to throat, like you're just bowing everything into your heart. Press the palms away and up, reach up, lengthen up. Exhale, bend the elbows, cactus arms.
Inhale, reach up again, interlace. Exhale, fold forwards. Steadiness or stillness. Doesn't matter, just breathe your breath. Interlace the hands and inhale, come up. Exhale, twist to the left, right hand to the left, knee, left hand behind. Lengthen up as you inhale and twist slowly as you exhale. Turn the gaze forwards, inhale, reach your arms up. Twist to the right, exhale. Breath in to lengthen and a breath out to twist. Turn the gaze forwards, release it, and get you lie down onto your back. And we take a little sip of stillness, of shavasana. If we're in classroom together, I'll probably keep you here for a little longer. But we're just gonna lie down long enough to let all of that good work sink in, all that awareness, beautiful fluid movement, any effort that you applied. We lie down, let the breath settle, and give the body a few moments of rest before we seal the practice together. Take a moment to invite your awareness back into the body. As if you could pull your awareness into the whole of the body. Like you'd pour water into a glass. And it just adapts, feels the shape of the glass. Aware of the earth underneath you, supporting you, lifting you up. Take an arm above the head, doesn't matter which one, and roll out to that side. With that first side that comes up, rest. Imagine you could rest yourself like an inch into the earth. Let yourself sink down. And press into the earth to come up. Take a seated posture to finish off. Just a little bit extra stillness. Eyes closed if that's comfy. Otherwise, a soft gaze in front. So once again, feel those parts of your body that are in contact with the earth. To allow for that downward and inward action into it. And just as equally, light lifting up and out into the spine. And to feel the fluidity of a fairly relaxed breath here in and out of the body. Bring the palms together in front of the heart. Bow the head slightly. Thank yourself for getting on the mat today. Moving with awareness. Ultimately help you feel good. If this is a state, how you feel right now, that you want to take with you into the rest of your day, just acknowledge that, be aware of it.